Thank you. There is no better sales environment. Okay. But face to face is difficult sometimes. I used to get on airplanes every week and fly to people, fly to customers. I talk on the phone and then I'd fly. I mean, it was a lot of time and talk about jet lag and everything. And then some of us get stuck texting and emailing. When does the actual conversion happen? When is it most likely to happen? The conversion, when someone says that wonderful word, yes, yes, Brent, I want to do this. Yes, Mike, here's my card. How do we pay it? Do you have financing? Can you give me a discount because I'm a nice person today?
Face to face.
What is that perfect environment? I think it's Zoom. What is Zoom? Zoom is a free video conferencing communication platform. Can be used through your computer, desktop, or mobile app. Not my watch yet. Not my Apple Watch, which I love, by the way. I have actually done sales through my Apple Watch. Do you guys believe me or not?
Wow.
I'll be out running. I love to run. Okay. It's hard to run in the winter here, but when I go running and all I take is my watch. I listen to music, audio books, podcasts, and my little, what do they call these, earbuds or whatever. And someone will call me. I actually, for $10 a month, I can get phone calls through my, instead of taking my phone with me, this heavy 1 pound phone or whatever it is. I take phone calls. I talk to people while I'm running. I have actually closed, my word of honor, people using this. But someday maybe we'll have Zoom so I can, while I'm running, I can actually look at people too.
You have to add a line on your thing there, Claude. You can close in your underwear.
You could, yeah. Well, you don't want me to stand up, right? Okay. I'm wearing SpongeBob boxers. It's not so bad. I'm wearing my jeans. It allows users to connect online for video conference meetings, webinars, and live chat. It became very popular during the pandemic. I was using it way before the pandemic. Before the pandemic and before Zoom, I was using Skype. There's also some other applications out there. I use FaceTime, which is a dedicated Apple video conferencing, but it's not as good as Zoom, in my opinion. 50% of the market have Apple phones. The other 50 have Androids. So not everybody can use FaceTime.
Is Zoom the only one you can do group like this, or could Skype do that as well?
Google, I wish Hugo Millar was here. Google has a chat. I don't personally like it as much. And there's a couple others. Help me out. There's the other one that we were using for a while. Some of them, the one thing about Zoom is it's easy to use. You can use it in a browser or you can use the dedicated app, which I recommend if you're going to be communicating with people. I think it's the easiest one to use. There's a little technical stuff. You can get really stuck in the preferences and stuff in Zoom. But basically, if you use the default system, it's not that hard. I use Zoom as my main means of communication for training, prospecting, creation of marketing, clips. My scheduled calendar automatically sends, for you guys in consulting and coaching out there, my calendar automatically sends my Zoom link to people besides my phone number. I want them on Zoom. My perspective story, I used to fly.
What about WhatsApp too? WhatsApp, did you mention it?
WhatsApp?
WhatsApp?
Tell us about it. Is that a video system too?
It's a secure, I don't even know that much about it. I just use it all the time. And it's a way to do the tech guys. Tell us about it.
It's a way to do FaceTime if you're not on an Apple phone, if you have an Android.
Okay. Yeah.
It's awesome. It's really good.
Other system. How about Voxer?
Free and secure.
I know some guy, Brandon Simmons, loves Voxer. Does that have video in it too, or strictly audio?
I'm sorry, were you talking to me?
Anybody, sure.
Voxer's just audio, and you can send like little two-way messages with it for the free version.
Okay.
What's up? Like, I can talk to my friends in Belgrade or London, and it's free, and you can see their face, and it's secure, so it's great.
Maybe I think I have to get that. I'm gonna make
you need to look it up. Yeah,
I'm gonna get it. WhatsApp, right?
APP. Yeah,
we were just in Costa Rica, yeah. And that's how they a lot of people talk was on WhatsApp.
Yeah,
WhatsApp.
Great.
A lot of our virtual assistants in Philippines use WhatsApp. A lot of people, yeah. a lot of countries.
Like I call my taxi in San Diego or whatever, but when I go to Belgrade, I just WhatsApp him, and the message goes straight through.
It also gives you the ability, Claude, if you have an Apple phone and you want to do FaceTime with an Android phone.
Okay. Good tips here. Thank you, guys. Yeah. It's all about communication. Make it as easy as possible for the prospect to communicate with you. Just you guys see right here. What do I always have in Zoom? I always have my phone number. I want to talk to people. I want to practice my rule of thumb. I went skiing yesterday. I must have talked to 25 people on the chairlift. You got a captive audience, right? Hi, are you visiting? What do you do for a living? Oh, is sales a challenge for you? How about real estate? It's great to talk to people on the chairlift if they want to talk. Absolutely. Face-to-face is the perfect sales environment. And that's why I'm a big proponent of Zoom. Marketing tips. Go to GoDaddy. And I said this earlier, create your Zoom link. Create a simple Zoom link. ZoomDave.com, ZoomJessica.com, ZoomBowers.com, something like that. So they can just put it, they can just go, everybody has the Zoom app. Or they can go right into their browser and do it. Add your name, email, and phone number when your face is on the screen. Make it easy for people. The psychology of video conferencing, video sales. What is the different ways we communicate? What's the most productive type of meeting? Obviously, face-to-face. That's why I do this with you guys every Monday. Dave.
How do you get the custom Zoom? Again, I was taking notes. But...
I use GoDaddy. Like it because it's quick, it's simple, it's easy. It's like $10. And what you do is you get, instead of using the Zoom link, you create your own link if nobody else is using it. I just use ZoomClaude.com. I know Brandon Simmons uses it. Justin uses it. And or call it the title of your business. JessicaHealth.com.
It's an annual, you pay just $10 for the year or something?
Yeah, that's it. And I think it just makes it easier, or it's more memorable to people. Instead of giving them a business card or exchanging all this information, you can just say, hey, go to ZoomClaude.com tomorrow. I leave it on all day long. And if I'm not in a conference already, I'll be glad to speak with you. You think somebody could remember Zoom Claude or Zoom Joe or Dave or Jessica? Just make it easy for them.
Question on that, Claude. Do you get, like, say somebody enters your room, do you get on an alert or something where you could, like, capture them if they were kind of as, like, a phone call or something like that?
Not that I'm aware. It's a great point. I'm not aware of it. Sometimes people will pop up and I'll say, hi, who are you? And they'll either be embarrassed and get off real fast, truth be told. Okay. Or they'll say, hi, this is Joe Blow. I was on your webpage and you said, go to ZoomClaude.com. Oh, Joe, could you come on? I'll be done with this meeting in 15 minutes. Joe, can you come on in 15 minutes? And I got a gift for you. Always create that incentive. The psychology, what is the psychology of being on video all the time to attract more people? So people do pop in occasionally and just say, hey, I can talk with you in 15 minutes, in 1 hour. Give me your phone number. I'll text you or come on in a little while when I'm free. Does that help you, Mike?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. Bottom line, what's our goal every day? What's our routine, the big R? What's our routine?
Talk to five people.
Talk to five people. Make five offers every day. You know, what's the worst they can say when you make an offer after you've had a guts conversation with them? Hey, Mike, you told me you don't have enough leads. The leads you have are think about it, or they don't qualify. And it's kind of feast and famine. One week you have a lot of leads, but they're not quality. And next week, the other. Suppose we could find a way to fix that real fast and you make a lot more money. Is that something we want to talk about?
Yeah.
Yeah. You want to meet on Zoom in about 15 minutes? Just go to Zoom, Claude, and let's talk about that. And if you want to ask me some questions, I can even record it for you. How's that sound? Mike?
Yeah, sounds good.
Oh, good, good. That's the interaction you need to go to the bank every day, every week. You heard Brent before. Okay, a lot of my students, some of them make more money in a week than other people make in a year. It's amazing. And they only do one thing well. They communicate well. They use a gut system, a question-based emotional system, and they have the, and they're using the technology to take advantage of this face-to-face that we have here. It's Guts and Zoom is based on the premise that emotional selling gets you there very quick, whereas your competition is using intellectual presentations, okay? It gives them, when you do an intellectual presentation with somebody and they pick your brain and they say, I'll think about it, I'll talk to my spouse, send me more information, you're not closing, you're not going to the bank, okay? Guts is about, it's a little bit more aggressive, assertive, but you're dealing with someone who has an immediate emotional need. And I think a video allows you to do that. The best environment for the system is personal, face-to-face, where you can read more than the tonality of the voice on a phone, but the physical expressions. What happens when anybody ever talk to somebody and they're doing this? Okay. What does that tell you about their attention span, to what you're doing?
Not all there.
It's not there, man. Look what I can do on Zoom, by the way. How about that, huh? Anybody like balloons?
Mm-hmm.
I just.
How about confetti?
How about it's magic? It's Zoom magic. How about two thumbs up? Fireworks. We can do all this. Do you think it gets a smile or a laugh on people?
Definitely. Can we? How do you do that?
You go into preferences in Zoom.
Okay.
And your settings for that. I think this is, I am part of a beta testing in Zoom that allows me to do this. Zoom gets a little difficult. You have to get into the really deep into Zoom. It has different levels. And you got to go online into the preferences. And then there's a sub preference area. And it allows you to do a lot. There's a million settings in Zoom. That's where it gets a little crazy. But you still, in the beginning, keep it very simple. Okay. You can do so many different things on it. But when you can read someone's face, their eyes, their emotions, okay, their hands, when they're leaning forward and you're talking, do you think that gives you clues about closing or interest or emotion?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, absolutely. Go ahead.
I just Zoomed my business name and it's only $11.50 a month, a year.
Okay. There you go. It just zoomdave.com or zoomdavid.com or Skullnick?
No, zoomthedogman.com.
Zoomthedogman.com. Okay. The dog man. Simple. Can everybody remember that? Mm-hmm. But they can't remember those Zoom links unless they copy and paste them and save them somewhere. So use a simple one. Follow up. I do follow up. Everybody I talk to, I send a follow-up video on Zoom. Zoom has something now called, I think it's called Clips. Or you can just do it yourself with QuickTime. But actually in Zoom now, I don't know if it's in the free model, but you can actually create short clips out of Zoom. They have a new button. They're always update. They must update Zoom. It's almost like every week, every 2 weeks. So you have to stay on top of it and make sure you're having the latest system. But I create little follow-up videos to people. Hey, Mr. Bauer, Senior, it was so nice to meet you today and speak with you. I'm a big fan of your son. Listen, I have a free book for you. Why don't you meet me to 2:30 on Zoom, zoomclaude.com. Boom. I'll send them a little video or something. Follow-up. How important is video follow-up psychologically? A video follow-up, 15, 30 seconds. Do you think that makes an impression on people? I do. Yes. How many people here get, besides, I do this all the time, but how many people here on a rate, do you, do, does, Salesmen are kind of lazy, aren't they? A lot of salespeople.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How hard is it to make a little video, even if you know you can't do the sale, they don't qualify, but maybe they will someday, and you send a little video. Hey, Mike, Claude Diamond here. Really enjoyed our conversation and meeting you today. If you have any questions or is anything else I can do for you, please feel free to call me. My phone number and my Zoom link are in the bottom of this email. So I take a Zoom, I make a short video, you hit the little arrow that goes up and you attach it into your email, and then you send it. And in the subject line, put personal email for John and Mary Smith from Brent, from Claude, from Dave, from Jessica. And just put that in there. That makes you, does that make you unique in terms of personal attraction marketing? Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. The advantages, it's efficient. No more driving to meetings. No more breakfast, lunch meetings. Better working from home. Better coffee, cleaner bathrooms, right? Oh, yeah. It's easy to use and learn. Zoom has great tutorial videos built into their system. Also, YouTube has a million YouTube videos and tutorials, all for free. But you might want to just start with the dedicated Zoom videos. And there's a lot of great free information on how to use this marvelous application. Using the phone is fine, but video allows you to get a better read on the prospect. Are they paying attention? Are they truly interested? Okay. If you get somebody on Zoom and they're playing with their kid or their dog, or it's a really noisy restaurant or something like that, is it going to work as well?
Mm-hmm.
No. So when you have dedicated meetings with people and they schedule with you, make sure in your instructions you say, be in a quiet place where we can have a productive conversation. And have good, and see if you can have good Wi-Fi or cellular connection. Okay. I've done it with people in busy places, and the background noise is very distracting sometimes. How about driving, zooming while people are driving? I get that all the time. What do you guys think about that? I'm always worried that someone's going to watch the screen and I'm going to be, I don't want to watch somebody get in an accident. Okay. Absolutely. Presentation. Hey, Todd, go ahead.
When you're on a Zoom with somebody like that and they're driving, or you could tell there's distractions, do you proceed with the call or do you try to reschedule?
No, I go for it.
Okay.
When do you kiss the pretty girl?
At the door.
No, when they're in the car.
How many in the car, right? Hopefully. Yeah, it's the best thing about not having a stick shift. I'm not going to go there anymore. if somebody calls you up, where'd Alex go? I lost him.
I'm here.
There you are. Alex. Alex, hi. I saw your video, your webpage. I just talked to one of your students, man. I think you walk on water. Can I talk to you for a few minutes? I'm on a break from work, and I'm really interested in your program, man.
Yeah. You go for it. You have a conversation.
Go for it. So the answer to your question, Alex, is it depends. Mm-hmm. Is it a cold call? Is it a follow-up, a referral? If it's a really serious call, I pull over on the road, right? I pull over the road. It might be a $25,000 sale.
Yeah. I was asking on their behalf. I'm not going to be distracted. I'm saying if they're distracted.
Do you think you can ask them to pull over yes, you can reschedule. But if you get it, it all depends. You know, what's the quality of the prospect you contact? They contacted you. What I always ask this question, Alex, what is the value of a warm prospect who contacts you? What is the value?
It's multiple times what they pay you.
It's huge, isn't it?
Yeah.
And if they contact you face to face on Zoom, isn't that as good as it gets? Yeah. So talk to them a little, maybe reschedule if you need more time, or sometimes when you're in the car, it's not always the best connectivity, is it?
Right.
Yeah. I think the most thing is, can you capture their phone number, which you can do on your phone, but I don't believe you can do that on Zoom. So the first thing you say is, "Hey, Alex, I don't have. I'm in the car. You're in the car. What's your best phone number? And when I get home or to the office, I will call you personally."
Got it.
Yeah. Okay. Does everybody have a pad and paper in their car, by the way? I do.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's just easier than while you're driving or you're busy texting it into a device, right? Sometimes it's just easier to write things down. Always have one of these. So there's a lot of advantages there. Recording and legal, just a little legal thing here. Depends on your state. Some states you can record phone calls without permission. It's a unilateral state. Some states you need permission. In Zoom, if you notice, there's always a pop-up when you do recording, whoever it is. Make sure if you're training a student, for my coaches and consultants out there, make sure your contract says that many times if you don't want to be recorded, please let me know. We do record for, what do they always say, for training purposes. Maybe you want to, when you're recording somebody, do you want to use segments for commercial purposes? Maybe you did a really great role play or had a very topical discussion. Would you love to take that clip and put it in YouTube and get yourself another 50 warm prospects? Absolutely. But I always ask permission. And I have it in my contract too, that I will on recordings use it. But before I publicize anybody's face or anything, I always ask permission on that. Questions on that legal aspect there? Okay. Live broadcast. There's a button in, let me see if I can show it on here. Do you guys see my screen? You can sign, I haven't clicked it, but I can broadcast a discussion with a private group or a webinar, or I can broadcast it live on Facebook, YouTube, or Twitch. Okay. Live broadcasts on Zoom, real easy to do. Instead of spending a fortune on StreamYard or there's a couple other things that are where you can actually broadcast on one at a time of the most popular pages. It's great for marketing, by the way, if you're having a general discussion on that. On YouTube, Guts is about confidence. It's about positive assertiveness. It's about making offers. I believe in making offers all the time, every day. When you speak to those people, hey, can I make you an offer? Hey, Mr. Bowers, can I make you an offer today? I really enjoyed this conversation. I've made a decision. I'd love to do business with you somehow. Can I make you an offer? It's okay to say no. Yeah,
please. Oh, sure.
Boom. You make an offer. What's the word? Maybe, you know, it's a good conversation. You're both on a little bit of a high. They're a natural high. What's the worst they could say? No. Or do you have financing? Or can you make it work? Always make offers and do it face to face, right? Best environment in the world. It can be for another meeting. It can be for a contract. Hey, Mr. Pardo, if I send you an agreement right now or a letter of intent with three offers on your property, can you get back to me before 4:30 today if I do that?
Yeah, I can do that.
Oh, you're great, man. Thank you so much. Boom. You can always make offers, contracts, negotiations, a closing, to do coaching, to do sell them a product information package, to do the real estate deal, whatever you're selling. Make an offer. Because once they get off the phone, what happens? What happens to your connectivity? Does it go up, down? Go. Once they get off the phone with you,
It goes down.
Yeah. Use the moment. It's a magic moment when you're on video with a prospect, cold, warm, follow up, whatever. You get them on video. You've got a chance. The best opportunity you'll ever have to go to the bank, no matter what you're selling, what you're negotiating. Absolutely. Screen share, wonderful tool. We're doing it right now. Use it all the time to share things on your screen. You can share other web pages. I use it all the time. And it's just a great way to send information. Backgrounds, you guys know about that. You go into your mind map and you go into, excuse me, you go into Zoom. And let me see if I can change that. And you guys know all about that. You can change your back. You can put a snowstorm behind you. You can put the mountains, the most beautiful office in Beverly Hills behind you. You can do all that. Brent has Brent and Alex, I think. I don't know. Alex, is that your real background or? Okay.
Yeah, real background.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Okay, so say you're in, you're doing your laundry or something like that. You don't want to show that in the background, right? You guys who know me, I'm on the treadmill sometimes in my messy garage. I can change the background. Okay. Body language, smiling, sometimes leaning forward. Oh, you know, you can use all that on video. Practice listening. It's common sense here. Be yourself when you're on video. You guys, what do you think? You know, what's my opinion on scripts?
Scripts are caca.
Yeah. Scripts suck. Yeah. Just be yourself. Maybe if you have certain questions or information you need, 5 or 10, write them down ahead of time. Have them on an index card or something. You always have something to talk about. Before I have hard meetings with people, I do a little research on them. I might just Google them, see what they do, what real estate company they're with, or what business they're with, or what videos they've put up. And I'll take a few notes before I meet with somebody if I have the time. Absolutely. But be yourself. Don't have the noisy background. We talked about that. And there's just so many different things here. I'll send this all to you guys today. Last word, comments, questions. I use Zoom every day. I leave it on sometimes. I use it for marketing, for follow-up. I upload videos sometimes from a group call, sometimes from a private call with permission. It's probably the number one application that I use to make my business hum. There is no substitute for face-to-face.
I have a question for you, Claude.
Sure.
When you're talking about taking notes when you're driving, for those of us who don't have a good-looking blonde chauffeur, what are we supposed to do?
You want me to tell you the truth?
No, lie to me.
Lie to me, lie to me. I always, next to my bed, in the bathrooms, everywhere I go. I have
a voice recorder on my phone.
Yeah, I always have pens and little pads everywhere. I even have composition books. I think I've showed you the little guys like, yeah, Post-its. Okay. My Denver Bronco Post-its or whatever you want to use. Even because it's the ability to write something down. It just works for me.
If you get a young assistant sometime, they're not going to be able to read the cursive. So you're going to have to relearn to print anyway.
Yeah. I mean, you can, if you have your phone nearby and you're not using it after the actual call, you can hit record. Sometimes I send myself a message with phone numbers and things. Sometimes I just hit the on a message feature. I hit the microphone and I'll send myself a message.
Okay.
But honestly, most of the time, I always have a pen and pad nearby. It's just, it works for me. Good question. Absolutely. Anybody else?
I have a voice recorder app on my phone. I use it all the time while I'm driving.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Anybody ever do your exercising or anybody ever get an idea at 2:30 in the morning and you woke up with this great idea? Mm-hmm. Follow up or something to remember. What do you guys do? Do you just let it disappear?
No,
I've got a little notepad by the back, a little notebook and pen.
Yeah.
But then I can't read it in the morning because I just scribble it because I want to go back to sleep.
Emailed my accountant at 5 a.m. this morning, talked into my phone and knocked it out.
I think about it until 6 a.m. It keeps me up all night and then I forget about it when I wake up.
How many people here exercise as part of their routine and get, I swim every day, I run. Swimming is the worst. Because I'll be doing laps, 20, 30, 40 laps, and I'll get this idea. And I actually I have to get out of the pool, stop my stopwatch, go into my little bag, and I have a little notepad. And I'll write that idea, and then I'll dive back in the pool. I mean, maybe that's a little anal, but sometimes, do you ever get these great ideas, you don't want to lose them?
The Keith Richards story with satisfaction. He woke up in the middle of the night and he had this dun, 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 in his head, and he wrote it down. He got up in the morning, he didn't even know what the hell it was.
Yeah. It was just that good thing. Yeah. So anyway, how many people here are using Zoom already? Show of hands. How many people are going to use it a little bit more? Absolutely. And it'll just help you to make more money, communicate better with people. When people see your face, are you creating an impression, a memory in their mind? Mm-hmm. As opposed to doing this stuff.
Yeah.
You know? Oh, Brent. See, Brent's got a little, I don't even know how he did that. Is that a reaction? We have that reaction button.
It's under the reactions.
Oh, I can do it. Yay. But this is my favorite. You know, the confetti and one V. I don't, it's a setting somewhere in there. Two thumbs up is the fireworks. Mm. It's all fun. You guys, if you want to call me, I'll be driving back to San Diego on Friday. Just give me a call if you have a question or a role play or anything. Have a great week, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. Take care.
Bye.
Let's find some music. We need some music.
We get no satisfaction.
Dude, no satisfaction.